everyone. Thanks for joining Oh Sugar. I'm Elise Gamble. Today we are going to be changing my Dexcom G6 CGM sensor. So grab your juice boxes and let's go. Today we're going to be changing my Dexcom G6 sensor. One thing I love about having a CGM or a continuous glucose monitor is that it monitors my sugar so I don't have to prick my fingers, which is great right now with all of the germs and stuff. You don't want to get infected. And the great thing about Dexcom is that there's an app that you can share it with your endocrinologist so they can get a full report on everything. And you can share it with your family. So if you're going low, your family knows you're going low. If you're going really high, your family knows you're going high. And it also will alert you in the middle of the night if you're going really low or something, and you'll get this like, and you can personalize and customize all of those options for yourself, for your ranges, and what number you want to be your low and what number you want to be your high. So I find it to be a really helpful tool, but there are other options too, like the Libre. The Libre is 14 days, and you have to wave it on your arm to collect data from the last 8 hours, which, I mean, that works for some people. For me, it doesn't. But Dexcom is only 10 days, so today we're on our 10 day. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go onto our phone and we're gonna go to our Dexcom app. We're going to press the stop sensor button, and this is gonna stop the current sensor that we have. Then I'm going to remove my old sensor. Well, before I show you my belly, let me just remind you that I just had a child, so please be kind. So what I'm gonna do is, let's see if I can move this slightly back. I'm just going to take my sensor, which you can see is fairly small with a transmitter in it, and I'm just gonna rip it off like a Band-Aid. And you can see right here, that is as big as an eyelash. That's as much as it's going in me every single time. And then when I take it off, I wanna make sure not to hurt myself with the little needle on the back, but I just take my sensor out this way and pull it out. So then this will go into your next sensor for the next 3 months. And then you'll dispose of this in your disposal kit, whatever you find to be helpful for that. And then what you will do is you will take one alcohol wipe and you will wipe the heck out of this, because this has been on your body, you've been showering everything with it. So make sure to wipe that. And then pick another spot on your abdomen and use another alcohol wipe, and you will wipe your abdomen with that. And one thing I found is that they have a really helpful video on their app if you want to do it, but these are just some tips and tricks I found that helped me. On the back, you'll have all of the codes that you'll need and a scan. You can either scan it or you can enter manually the sensor number. So I just open it. I'll type in my sensor number, and which is also located here and scanned here. And I will remove these. And then I'm gonna put it on the area of my belly that I want it to stay on. So I'm gonna put it, I don't know if you guys can see, right here. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna switch the little orange tab to either the right or left so it pops off. And then I'm gonna push in. And it's in. But while I'm entering the transmitter to get it going, I have to make sure to enter it kind of like I'm going like this. I like to put this end first in, otherwise it takes a lot more toggling, and since this is already attached to your belly, it's really not helpful. So anyway, I'll just put that in. I will start sensor, press start sensor on my on my app, and then after that we will have 2 hours where it's like warming up. So if you need to check your blood sugars, you're gonna have to do the finger sticks. But then it should be good to go. Sometimes in the 24-hour period, you'll get like a crazy high or a crazy low. Just make sure to calibrate that. And then also when you're sleeping, sometimes if you roll over on it, it'll give you like a really fast low. That's usually a compression low, but again, it's always best to like double check with your fingers. So anyway, I hope those were some helpful tips for you, and have a great day. Cheers.